Hey guys, it's Nicole, and this is going to be a video on why I think nursing schools are so tough on their students. When I was a student, if you were late, you got written up. If you weren't prepared, you got written up. If you didn't know the objectives of the clinical, you got written up. I felt like I was getting it from each and every end. But now that I'm a nurse, I really appreciated my school's stringentness as far as making me a better student, therefore a better nurse. Let's say you have a patient at 8 o'clock, they had perfect vitals and you gave them their medications for the morning. At 8:15, the monitor tech rolls in and tells you that your patient had 10 beats of VTAC and now is in a normal sinus rhythm. You go into the patient's room, notice they're asymptomatic, and check some vitals. You then write on your notepad that you're going to call the physician with an update in change in patient condition and get some orders later, but not right now. You see your other patients, give them their meds. 30 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours rolls by, and then you get a call saying that your patient's asystole. When they go back to look at those records, they're going to want to know why did it take you an hour, almost 2 hours, to even initiate a telephone call to a physician. And I know what you're thinking, I'm never going to do that. But when you have 4 or 5 patients and they all have 8 o'clock medications and each patient has 10 medications that you have to give, your day, your morning can get very busy very fast. Let's say you didn't wait the hour and a half to call a physician. You called him immediately when you saw the rhythm. You call him, he then gives you orders for an echo, a 12 lead, and cardiac enzymes. He also wants you to get a cardiology consult on call. You say, thank you, sir. You repeat the order and you say, have a good morning. You write it on your board and you never put those orders in at all. Let's say the next day your patient codes. The physician, risk management, and your charge nurse are going to want to know why didn't you input those orders given since your patient's condition had changed and you had already called the physician. People are not going to be double checking your work or making sure that you do these things. Sometimes your patients' lives depend on what you follow up on and what you don't follow up on. Let's say you give a bolus to a patient and then you notice they have crackles. You want to stop the infusion, but you haven't called the physician yet, so you keep it running and then you forget. Let's say your patient goes into congestive heart failure and they have heart insufficiency and they ended up having some sort of lethal rhythm. Since you never called the physician and never checked up on your patient's status, that's on you. Nursing is all about learning how to juggle different things, multitask, and organize your day. Your patients depend on you to where if they have an abnormal response or a change in condition, they expect you to call the physician with orders. This is what you're supposed to do. This is why you have boards, because you know how to look at a situation and tell whether it's abnormal or not. And once you realize and know that it's abnormal, you call the physician for orders or you do any sort of nursing interventions. But when there is a 30-minute, 40-minute, 2-hour lag time on getting orders or doing nursing interventions, you put your patients at risk. And I know what you're thinking, well, isn't someone going to check on that? No. When you're a nurse, those patients are your sole responsibility. No one's going to check on whether you cut those fluids off. No one's going to check on whether you call the doctor for your patient's VTAC beats. And no one's going to help your patient eat. You have to do everything and anything, and this is why you're a nurse and you're awesome. But this is what a lot of people have issues with when they start out being new nurses. They don't know how to multitask or juggle. They were gonna call for the echo and they forgot. They were gonna call for the chest x-ray and then they forgot. And then that particular moment causes another patient condition because you forgot to do that and then you're in trouble. I love tough nursing schools. I came from a very tough nursing school. If you were late, if you didn't have your objectives for the day, you were going to get into trouble. Whether you were going to get written up or have an additional assignment, the school was tough. And I really, really didn't appreciate that. But now as a nurse, I come to work 30 minutes early. I know what I need to do as a professional, and I'm ready and willing to do the best I can. And I attribute that to my nursing school. So for every student out there who has a tough nursing school and you don't know why they have all these rules and it's ridiculous, it's to make you a better nurse and make sure that you have higher standards when it comes to patient care. And it does translate. When I went to training, I didn't have to modify or change my personality or the way I handle things. Because as a nursing student, I was rapid with my decisions, calling the doctor and making sure my patient got the best care they could. That's my little 2 cents on why I think nursing schools are a little tough these days. Please tell me what you think. If you guys have any questions or comments for me, as always, please put them on the bottom. I love your feedback and your support, as always, and have a good day, guys.